We start off with the epic rally on Wall Street and these words from White House advisor and familiar face, Larry Kudlow.
The new numbers coming in, retail sales, industrial production, low inflation, a rock steady dollar, trillions of dollars of capital from all over the world is coming into the United States because our economy, our investors, our workforce are crushing it right now. We are crushing it.
And America is crushing it. The Dow jumping more than 400 points as trade fears ease and Walmart came in with gangbuster earnings. It's the best day for the Dow since April. All the major indices are back within striking distance of all-time highs. So if you're betting on strong growth here at home, do you bet in the major sectors that we're working today, mainly financials and industrials? Karen's long in the banks, of course, as you know. Do you keep betting on this group?
Yes. That was a question.
Yes.
Right? Yes. The answer is yes. I think you stay with this group. I mean, the two-day, three-day sell-down, whatever it was, I think, you know, we had sort of rates come back in because of various global events, mainly Turkey. So to me, I think Turkey will be sort of a passing fancy. I like the banks. They're so geared to the economy. And I think we are going to see more inflation. I'm surprised we haven't seen it all tick up already, but I still want to be long these names.
The reason why we highlighted the financials, amongst other reasons, is that in today's rally, we really saw a technology lag. And that was sort of an interesting sort of turn of events. Yeah. Within a market that was so strong, we saw the financials, we saw industrials, we saw materials lead the markets
higher.
It's
been the story the whole year where this rotation, you have some lagging sectors, leading sectors, the same amount of money kind of churning around. I didn't get that excited about today. We're up 400 points on the Dow. Yeah, we started the day off with some not so great housing numbers here in the U.S. And the housing stocks themselves couldn't even get out of their way. So for every good sign, there's a bad sign out there. And we're still in this churn. And you know, we had talks that there's going to be talks about potentially a trade deal with China. They're just talking about it. So this is very thin.
So you're saying talks about talks?
Talks about talks.
It's better than no talks.
It's better than no talks.
Yes.
It is.
Are they?
But then when you hear Larry Kudlow this morning go like full Trump with all of his, I mean, it just seems like, you know, listen, we're not talking that average hourly wages, inflation adjusted in July, were the lowest print in 2012. It was actually, so wages aren't going up. Their wages are not crushing it right now. And so the fact is that inflation, if we do see a spike, given everything that's going on with the trade situation, we have a scenario where the U.S. consumer could get badly hit really quickly. And I just want to make one other point. You talk about this rotation. I thought technology closed very badly. Semiconductors closed on the low. Google closed on its low. Netflix is in correction, major correction territory, closed on its low. So I don't really believe you can have a meaningful breakout above the prior highs if you do not have FANG doing it. Now, that being said, Apple keeps surging ahead, closed at a new all-time high. I just think the most important thing is let's see how NVIDIA reacts tomorrow. It's down 10 right. bucks. That's a rounding error for this stock. But if you start losing these leaders, that's really the problem for the market.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't love the way technology acted today either, to be truthful. I do think that, you know, it shows you when you hear, you know, we're sending our undersecretary of trade to China to have conversations and the market reacts the way it does, how important trade is. Trade is the narrative right now that is just dominating the market in what direction we go. So I look at it and hear Larry's, you know, commentary, obviously saying that America's crushing it is a very, I mean, an incredible, positive to take out in a week that we've been, you know, having a little bit of turmoil. But in general, I don't know that I was really positive today about the way technology traded. I do agree with Dan on that front. Watching NVIDIA and sort of the earnings come out, it's a very crowded trade. It's going to be interesting to see how that trades tomorrow. And again, we're starting to see shorts come back into that sector, given the M&A profile isn't promising, given that no deals probably get done there. Shorts are now more comfortable to sell short those stocks. That's a little bit concerning for me right now.
Having technology, I don't want to say stutter, but slow down compared to the performance so far this year, it's only a problem if you don't believe other sectors in the market will catch up or pick up in their performance.
So the question is does the technology slow down? Is it just because it's being used as a cash register to get into something like the banks? Or is it because there's actually something fundamentally wrong with it, which I think is exactly Dan's point. Don't want to put words in his mouth, but if NVIDIA, they guide a little bit lower tonight, that's why it's down 4 or 5%. If that doesn't turn around and people don't think that you're going to get that earnings growth, then that would be a negative for the market as a whole.
I don't think that anything's fundamentally shifted from that perspective. I don't think the fundamentals of technology or why you don't technology have shifted dramatically enough to actually cause a massive pour out of capital from this sector. I do believe that it is being used as a bank account or sorts of funds to rotate into other sectors.
I agree with that. I think this is a trading-oriented issue, right? A rotation. And I really don't like to go with the rotation. We've seen so many times that tech FANG in particular, tech on the other side of momentum with banks, with industrials. To me, it's all about the fundamentals and when they report. The other thing, though, trade, this market is I think, the ballast is trade.
Yeah, but
that goes away.
I agree. And I just think the longer that we churn, the longer we don't give above the prior highs, it just puts the bull market really in question. And so that's why leadership is really important. And I just want to make one point about like Boeing today. I just heard you guys talking about it. I mean, Boeing's a stock that is down about 7% from the all-time highs made earlier in the year. It just rallied 5% off of its lows yesterday. When you see that sort of performance about talks on trade, then you have to start thinking about what are the worst case scenarios? What if this thing drags out much further than we expect? What if every time we see some sort of headline, you know, it's kind of interesting that no one, you know, the Turkey situation, it may go away, it may not. The first headline I saw this morning was our Treasury Secretary saying they're readying more sanctions against Turkey, okay? So this is just fuel to the fire. I think this has a potential to be a big war. I really do. Forget about, you know, what's going on with an autocrat in Turkey.
You mean a big trade war?
Yes,
right.
A big trade war.
And specifically
I think every one of our adversaries in this potential trade war know the incentive to drag this thing out is close to our midterm elections.
Right. In terms of what we saw today and what drove the rally, I mean, are we to take away from this that it is trade that is in fact going to be the driver of the market? It wasn't Turkey.
Turkey was a sideshow.
Trump, Turkey.
We actually had a lower dollar over the last 24 hours. I mean, we rallied a little bit today, but you know, the concern about the dollar was too strong is out of the market a little bit. That doesn't mean it's over, but it is 100% about trade. So Turkey, you have emerging markets slowing down. If you get some contagion, yes, that can be a problem. But it is really about this global trade story. If we don't have global trade, you're not going to have a higher stock.